I'm definitely a big advocate of OSINT, but, you know, on this channel, mainly I talk about OPSEC, which in time I'm going to be shifting gears because I definitely think that we also really need to evaluate OSINT. What's up, everyone? So today we have a question from Shoebhox, who says, after doing time, what's it like trying to find a career with a record? Also, are you in the IT field or want to get into IT, given your knowledge? So the answer to the first part of the question is it sucks. It's extremely difficult to find work as a felon if you're going for something that is like more white collar. That's why you see so many guys who just get out, who end up doing stuff with the trades or food service or stuff along those lines, which that's great. You know, if that's what they want to do, I'm all for everyone doing, you know, the job that they're good at or they enjoy doing. For me, like, you know, My fat ass isn't, you know, going to work construction. This is not happening, man. So yeah, to answer your question, for a while I was a security engineer at a great company. I loved working there. I actually just recently got laid off from there after about 2.5 years. I'd been doing documentation work for them. I've done a lot of different stuff for this company, and it was an amicable, you know, split. It was they basically ran out of work for me, which it's a great way to leave a job, in my opinion. You know, it is like you just crush it and they're like, hey, listen, you've done everything, we've, you know, like, there's nothing else. So that's how it was. And like, if you're interested in like my exact position and exactly what I did, I have a LinkedIn, Sam Ben. Okay, free to look it up. I'm definitely a big advocate of OSINT, but you know, on this channel, mainly I talk about OPSEC, which in time I'm going to be shifting gears because I definitely think that we also really need to evaluate OSINT, because I think they're very much two sides of the fence. With OPSEC, you're literally trying to prevent your enemies gaining information about you. You're saying, what am I putting out there? How can I prevent them from getting it? Or how can I manipulate it to make it look like it's a friendly movement when it's an enemy movement? You're managing your risk with the information that you're putting out there, whether you're putting it out there directly, indirectly, whatever. As with OPSEC, though, it's like, you know, you are looking for that information that's out there and trying to find it. And so it's like, you know, two sides of the table. It's like, you know, the black and the white spy. OPSEC is important to both of them. And they, you know, if they want to see what they're putting out there, they need to be able to, you know, take a realistic portrait of that. And being a good OSINT practitioner gives you the ability to evaluate OPSEC, in my opinion. I've done OPSEC investigations just on adversarial targets where I found, you know, so much information that, like, I don't need to launch an exploit. I can just put it all down. And, you know, I've handed documents to, you know, website owners and been like, you should make me an admin. You have a ton of vulnerabilities. You have, you know, your personal information's out there. Like, here's, you know, here's what your living room looks like, you know, because it was like the guy got a condo and you know, they had an ad with a picture of his living room and, like, did freaks people out big time. Like, sometimes you don't need to launch an actual exploit. You know, you can just get enough information to walk into a place, metaphorically speaking. It was difficult, you know, finding a job after getting out of prison. I was lucky enough, though, to have a really great friend, and some of you have seen him on this channel before. His handle on YouTube is CWade12C. He's not really active anymore, but I've known him for 15 going on 20 years, something like that, in between there. And basically, when I got out, he said, "Hey, man, like, what are you doing?" And I said, "Hey, man, I'm looking for work. What do you think I'm doing? You know, but I had to provide for my family." And he said, "Why don't you come work with me?" And I said, "That sounds great." And he ended up, you know, talking to the president, and he got me hired. And there I stayed for 2.5 years. So it was an interesting ride. But I was really thankful to that company, because if it wasn't for them, you know, it's that first hurdle of getting employment is super difficult. Like, in the month that I was out, I probably applied to 80 places. And, you know, like, die pretty nuts. They only Google you and that's it. Yeah, OSINT, right? You know, the ability to find information out that's freely available out there. So those are all, you know, considerations. I think that, as I've said before, you know, for any issue that you have, there's a solution to everything. So the solution to that, for me, that I would advise people is education. You know, get the, even if there's certificates for like Coursera, hop on Coursera, and, you know, if you don't have money for it, just go to the financial aid section. It's not formal, like with FERPA. I know with FERPA, it's not formal, you know, like with a, you know, a federal grant or anything. It's just, you basically write down why you shouldn't pay for the course on Coursera, and you wait 4 weeks, and they usually approve you if you do a good enough job explaining your situation. For me, I was like, listen, I'm out of prison. I want to provide for my family. I want a better job. I want a better life. I made some mistakes, and I'm moving past them, and I'm trying to do better. And if they approve me, and they still, to this day, whenever I write the same statement, they always approve me for those courses on Coursera. And that's pretty awesome, because at the end of the day, there are courses on Coursera that if you take, you take a collection of five of them in like a professional track, you can get college credit for. So that's pretty awesome. You get free college credit and hack your way towards a, you know, a free degree. That's awesome in your own time, you know, that I really like. So that would be basically what I would advise people to do if they were in that position. Yeah, I love technology. I'm a complete nerd. Like the stupid AI pin that came out. I was like, this is awesome. And then I watched a couple of YouTube videos about it. They're like, you got a bunch of stuff wrong. The almonds don't have that much protein in them. And I was like, oh yeah, that's true too. I'm a nerd. That's what it is. I love technology. I love seeing that constant evolution of technology, and it's great. So I wouldn't want to be at anything else. I appreciate the question. I appreciate you taking the time to ask it. I love answering you guys' questions. Feel free to continue asking them down in the comment section. And I'll see you guys in the next video.